break your record.
Good. Welcome to another episode here at The Sports Life. Today we present to you the greatest baseball player of all time. In this episode, we will be talking about the legendary Babe Ruth, considered by many to be the greatest major league baseball player in history. As we all know, no great achievement comes without sacrifice, so stick around to hear what troubles Babe Ruth got himself into in his young years before he was even 8 years old, and how he was struck out by a 17-year-old female during one particular game. Babe Ruth sure did have a few quirks in his lifetime, but he is still a legend nonetheless. First, don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the bell, and comment. Let us know who you think we should feature next. Let's hit it! George Herman Ruth Jr., most famously known as Babe Ruth, is a legendary American baseball player who transformed the way people looked at baseball at a time when the world was just emerging from the Great Depression era. He was considered as one of the most famous personalities during the peak of his career in the late 1920s to 1930s, earning as much as $80,000 per year, a salary that was a little over that of then President Herbert Hoover. With that said, Babe Ruth was just as human as the rest of us, although many thought that his natural talent and charisma were the reasons that put him on top. It was his sheer determination and constant focus that helped pave the way to his stardom. Babe Ruth had his own share of mischief before he even reached the age of 8. He skipped schools, had run-ins with the law, got involved in petty thievery, got drunk on whiskey, and even chewed tobacco. All the trouble a little kid can cause, Babe Ruth caused. His father was exceedingly busy running a salon, and his mother was too sickly to properly care for him. The lack of parental guidance forced his parents to send him to a Catholic reform school, St. Mary's Industrial School for Boys, hoping that the stricter and regimented environment would somehow fill the space they could not occupy themselves. At St. Mary's School, every boy was required to learn a trade to prepare them for working life. Babe Ruth was supposed to be a shirt maker, but life had other plans for him. When his mother died due to tuberculosis, he became a permanent student resident at St. Mary's, and it was there that Babe Ruth found his calling for baseball. His mentor and father figure, Brother Matthias, one of the school monks, worked patiently with him to refine his skills in pitching, fielding, and hitting. When he was finally ready, the school sent an invite to the owner of the Baltimore Orioles, Jack Dunn, to explicitly show how Babe Ruth could play the field. It didn't take long to convince Jack Dunn, a mere half an hour, for him to watch the game and instantly offer a contract. At age 19, Babe Ruth joined the Baltimore Orioles. On introduction, the team soon referred to him as Jack's newest Babe, thus forever coining the term Babe Ruth. But within only a few months of joining the Baltimore Orioles, Jack Dunn ran into financial troubles and was forced to sell Babe Ruth to the Boston Red Sox. Babe Ruth started his career as a pitcher and later became the best left-handed pitcher in baseball. He won his first major league debut at Fenway Park on July 11, 1914, and pitched 7 innings for the win. However, due to a loaded roster, Babe Ruth was sent to the Boston Red Sox's minor league team, Providence Grays, where he made his first professional home run. From there on, his notoriety soared. From 1915 to 1919, he single-handedly helped win 87 games, including 3 World Series games, subsequently earning him an earned run average of 2.16. His batting also became so powerful that in 1919, he set a new world record for 29 home runs in a single season, a figure that was almost impossible to achieve during those early years when baseball was more about tactics than skill. Yet even with the great Bambino's laudable performance, the owner of the Boston Red Sox, Harry Frazee, decided to sell him to the New York Yankees on the provision of a personal loan, just to ease his financial burdens. In 1920, Babe Ruth joined the New York Yankees and history was written as he became a full-time outfielder. During his first season with the Yankees, he topped his previous record with a whopping 54 home runs and was given the nickname Sultan of SWAT. The Yankees drew a new record high of 1 million viewers in attendance, ultimately sealing the team's esteemed reputation in baseball. Babe Ruth did not stop there though, his stature continued to grow even more, in line with his batting average. In his second season, he hit an amazing 59 home runs, scored 177 runs, and recorded an unbelievable .846 slugging percentage. The 1921 Major League might have been his greatest performance in history. This was the making of a legend. When the New York Yankees moved to a new stadium in 1923, they labeled it the house that Ruth built. Babe Ruth became the highest paid baseball player of all time, and his prominence reached far across America. In 1926, he hit another new record of 60 home runs, and in the same season, teamed up with Lou Gehrig, forming a historic home run hitting duo that became so powerful and unrelenting they were nicknamed Murderers Row. They were regarded by sports enthusiasts as the greatest duo ever to play side by side. From 1920 to 1964, he led the Yankees to the top spot and helped them earn 29 American League pennants, as well as 20 World Series. In spite of all that, Babe Ruth also had his fair share of troubles. One time, in response to a taunting crowd, he jumped onto the stadium stands and attempted to pursue a heckler. As a result of this misbehavior, he was stripped of his captaincy and was suspended for a game. In 1929, he lost his first wife to a tragic fire accident in her new house, only to marry Claire Hodgson months later and adopt her daughter, Julia. In 1931, during an exhibition game, a 17-year-old female pitcher named Jackie Mitchell struck out Babe Ruth. However, it was speculated that it was just a publicity stunt, though nothing was ever confirmed. Even with all the other issues that surrounded Babe Ruth, by the end of his career, he still held one of the most revered records in the history of baseball, with a grand total of 714 home runs. It seemed nothing could have stopped this man from conquering any opponent he faced, but unfortunately, in the fall of 1946, he was diagnosed with a malignant tumor on his neck, and soon afterwards, his health began to deteriorate. On June 13, 1948, the Yankees officially retired his number 3 uniform. Also on that day, Babe Ruth's last appearance at the Yankee Stadium was photographed by Nat Fein, a photograph that later won the Pulitzer Prize. Babe Ruth was a true hero. He revolutionized the way baseball was played with his high-scoring home runs and powerful batting skills that won countless games. Emerging from the era of the Great Depression, this all happened during a time when people had only just begun to experience freedom and enjoy the gradual restart of a normal life. Babe Ruth became a household name attached to this wave of exhilaration, a symbol of a new age, a celebration of what it meant to win, and truly a force to be reckoned with. Following his death on August 16, 1948, over 100,000 people lined up to bid farewell to Babe during his funeral at St. Patrick's Cathedral in New York. Babe Ruth remains to be the greatest figure in the history of Major League Baseball, not only for his chart-topping records, but also for the way he played the game and how it influenced all walks of life, bringing hope and joy amongst the humdrums of everyday living. We hope you enjoyed this episode about Babe Ruth. See you on the next episode of The Sports Life for more fun, sports-related content.